Hi everyone, Tyler Skywalker here, and today I'm going to be doing a Fifth Doctor review of Resurrection of the Daleks. Now, I looked over my videos recently and I thought, oh, this is funny, I haven't done a Fifth Doctor review. And well, there's no real reason for it, I guess, other than, well, I don't know really. And I thought, well, it's best to do one of those, and I thought, what better place to start than with Resurrection of the Daleks. Yeah, now many of you probably thinking there are loads of better places to start. But I decided to go with this one because I'm doing quite a few Dalek episode reviews recently, so yeah, let's just get right into it. And it's not the most popular story. I mean, a lot of people dislike it, you know, think it's very violent and whatnot, and you know, the plot's just confusing, and I think I agree with a lot of those points. So, anyway, getting off, the start is quite interesting, because, I mean, you've got these people running out of a, not sure what it is, warehouse or something, and then they're all shot down by these strange people who then disappear, and as starts go, I think that's quite an intriguing one, to be honest. And, you know, a lot of the characters are quite likeable. Litten, I do quite like, and he shows up again in Attack of the Cybermen. And I think he's probably the best part, well, one of the best parts of both of those stories. He's a very good character. So, yeah, now, the story itself, it features Davros again, and, to be honest, it's, after Genesis, he's not at his best, to be honest, really. Sorry about that. But, yeah, because, I mean, I personally think he would have been better off than in Genesis, because every Dalek story since following Genesis up till the end of the classic series features Davros for no good reason, really, because, to be honest, he kind of weighs those stories down and takes away the threat of the Daleks themselves. Now, in Remembrance, it's done right, because despite him being in that right at the end, the Daleks are the main threat for most of it, because he appears just like right at the end of episode 4. So I think Remembrance gets it right, but Resurrection, Revelation, and Destiny all do it fairly wrong. They use Davros too much. Now, Revelation, I think I'm okay with that one using Davros, because that's more Davros' story than a Dalek story, in a lot of senses. But, to be honest, here it's quite bad, and Destiny is quite bad, so, anyway, the story itself, I think, the plot of this story, what is it? See, you got loads of different things going on. The Daleks seem to want to do everything at once. So, I mean, they want to conquer Earth using duplicates, they want to conquer Gallifrey using duplicates, they want to rescue Davros, they want to cure this disease that the Mavellan virus has affected them with. Nice bit of continuity throughout to Destiny, but that's another thing, since Genesis it all becomes continuity obsessed. And this story suffers from the way of that. And yeah, I mean, the Daleks just have too much going on, to be honest. They have too many plans, and you just think, please, one at a time. All of those elements would have worked well in their own story, but unfortunately, they're all crammed into this one story, and none of them really get a focus that much. Which is quite unfortunate, really. And while it does show the Daleks in a good light as strategists, it doesn't show them in a good light in any other sense, and to be honest, it just weighs down the story too much and makes it not as enjoyable. So, yeah, now, with that said, Daleks, the violence in this, I think there's something like, there's more deaths than there are cast members, because you have the ordinary people dying, then you've got the duplicates dying, and whatnot, and, yeah, you kind of see that. I'm not sure if that's a proven fact, but I wouldn't be surprised if it is. Now, yeah, that's quite unfortunate for this story. Now, I mean, there's some stories where it works to have a bloodbath, I guess. where, you know, loads of people die and whatnot, and it emphasised the effects, but here it doesn't. Here it just seems overly violent for the sake of being overly violent, and Eric Saward, the writer of this, hasn't really done a good job getting the violence right in this. Whereas it is got right in stories like Kay Sanchez Ani, for example, but here it's not so. Okay. And talk about Kay Sanchez Ani and whatnot. This, taking away the twin dilemma, a lot of this season has the same tone as Kay Sanchez Ani, like this dark tone for Peter Davison's last season, despite it often being said that, you know, the majority of Peter Davison's era is quite light in tone in a lot of ways. But here, the whole series, the whole season is quite dark, to be honest, and overly violent and whatnot, but it's only really done right in the caves of Androzani. And I'll review that another time. But anyway, back on to Resurrection of the Daleks. The Bomb Disposal Squad, I think, you know, they're quite agreeable. I always thought this should be a unit story, really. So you could easily have swapped out the Bomb Disposal Squad with a unit squad or something. But yeah, I think that's beside the point, really. Anyway, so when they're duplicated, they become quite mean and whatnot, and to be honest, after that, the plot in the warehouse kind of droops down and becomes quite boring. Because, I mean, you just got Tegan and the other woman who I can't even remember the name of. She might not have even been named in this story. Where they literally just, they don't get anything to do. It's just trying to escape. And then they get caught and they try to escape again, and to be honest, it's quite bad storytelling. And a bit lazy that bit's just kind of like left there. Now, the Doctor threatening to kill Davros, I think, in a way, there's people who accuse Eric Saward of always trying to get a gun into the Doctor's hand in every story. But, you know, here I think that moment would have worked if it had been expanded upon a bit more. But, you know, because you've got so many Dalek plot threads going on with all their different plans, that bit couldn't get expanded anymore, unfortunately. And, you know, it's a shame. I think that moment, that kind of, like, bit in the story would have been quite effective, to be honest. It's been the Doctor threatening to kill Davros and whatnot, going on about this moral dilemma. And to be honest, that could have been, like, the Do I Have the Right speech. That could have been a moment along the same lines of that, but unfortunately, it's not done well enough. And I think Peter Davison's performance is there for the most part, but nothing else goes as well because it's not as well written as it could have been. And yeah, it's unfortunate, really. It was a waste of potential. So now, finally, we have Tegan's farewell. Now, that bit, I would agree, is done very well, but again, it's squeezed onto the end, unfortunately, but it's a bit better than the Doctor's scene with Davros. And yeah, to be honest, it is quite good, and it's realistic as well, because I mean, it's probably the most realistic departure scene with Tegan leaving simply because she's growing tired of the lifestyle and tired of all the death. And, you know, out of all of the companions' departure scenes, that's probably the most real, grounded reason that you could have. It's a bit similar to Victoria's, I guess, but nevertheless, I think that moment's quite good, and it really hits the Fifth Doctor hard as well. You can tell that kind of, like, has an effect on him. And, well, it's funny, because when I think of Resurrection of Daleks, I don't think of it as Tegan's farewell story, because it's got so much other stuff going on about it, unfortunately. And yeah, that farewell isn't really into that at all until it actually happens right at the end, which is another unfortunate thing. So Anyway, now, there's one more thing I'd like to say. If you saw my previous video on my top 10 companions, you will know that Leela is my favourite companion. And during this, it has a moment where the Doctor's kind of like, you have a bit of a flashback thing where it goes through all his companions and all his previous selves. And you got that coming up on the screen when the Doctor's having his mind scanned for his duplicate to be made. And you may notice that it features every single companion and every single previous Doctor other than Leela. Yep, they missed out my favourite companion. Now, I'm not going to deduct points for that, but it's not good. It doesn't make me happy. Anyway, joking aside, that bit's not really too bad at all. But overall, I think the story deserves a 4 out of 10. It could have been so much better. It's too violent. Like I said before about common opinion, I agree with that. It's got too much going on. And, yeah, it's just a waste of potential, really. Some good moments, some good things happen in it, but overall, you know, 4 out of 10, it's not much more to say about that. So, yeah, now that's done. So, yeah, that was my review of Resurrection of Daleks. I hope you enjoyed it. And next week, I will be reviewing Spearhead from Space, and I also have another top 10 and another big finish review coming during the week. So, thanks for watching, everyone, and I'll see you all next time. Bye, everyone. I'm